Hey y'all, it's Laura, and I am back with Scraplift Sunday with my friend Miranda Weber. And we are scraplifting the lovely Virginia Walker, who is Gold Dove Crafts here on YouTube and on Instagram. And she had created this beautiful floral clustering that was a little bit larger at the top, spread out in the center, and then just kind of faded out toward the bottom. And I just really loved the shape of that floral cluster. And I have these two adorable photos of my twins at our local petting farm, and I thought these would be perfect to nestle in among some florals. Now, I've used most of the florals in my How to Kill a Kit with Style kit for February because, let's face it, I love florals. So I've already used a great deal of the fussy cut florals that I had cut out previously. And so I grabbed a Chamel Starshine paper that had a ton of beautiful roses in it. And I went ahead and cut out a whole bunch of those because the color scheme was fairly similar to the one in Chamel's Little by Little. So that is a little tip for you. If you've run out of one collection, you can look at that designer's other collections, and oftentimes you'll find the similar tones in their color schemes. And you can kind of tie together multiple collections by the same designer. Now, I'm taking these two photos and matting them onto some pink so they will pop up off that background just a little bit. And they're also wearing bright green shirts for their class. And one of those things that I get so irritated about with the school, class t-shirts should not come in neon green. It makes scrapping the photos from their field trips really frustrating because I don't love neon green. I can work with a little bit of neon green. It's fine. Like the leaves on this floral I'm playing with right now, that is completely fine. That doesn't bother me in the slightest. But bright neon green shirts in every single picture, yeah, that's annoying. That's really annoying. So not super excited about that aspect of the photos, but I do really love how this layout comes out. Now, I do have some of these beautiful hydrangea looking florals that came from the Little by Little collection, and I am going to pop those up onto adhesive foam to create a little bit of dimension on my layout. The rest of the florals will be taped and glued straight down onto the background so that there is levels within my page, and lots and lots of layering. I'm also trying to keep in mind I want some balance in my colors, so I want a little bit of yellow in multiple spots. I want the pinks in multiple spots and the blue as well, and so I'm trying to create a nice balance of those colors. Now, my floral cluster is significantly larger than Virginia's was in her layout. However, I am using two photos and she was just using the one, so I did know that that was probably going to happen. I had cut out extra florals just to be prepared for that, and once I had them in place, I felt like, you know what, I like it. I like the large, huge floral explosions that I make. When I'm playing with florals, it's very rare for me to go minimalistic because I just love them so much. And I thought, you know what, I've cut out all these flowers, I just might as well use them all. So I'm spreading a variety of larger florals and the smaller florals and everything in between. But I did start with the larger clusters, especially the ones that have multiple flowers or big leaves. I've positioned those first because it's much easier to tuck in your medium and smaller florals second after you have those larger pieces in place than it is to come back and try to find a space to make the larger ones fit. Now, I am overlapping them, and so you're not going to be able to see all of every flower, and that's okay. That's kind of the point of this style, of this clustering of flowers, is that you don't see all of everything. Now, if I was trying to conserve these flowers, I could cut off the bits that you can't see and relayer those into the cluster somewhere else, but in this particular instance, I'm not really worried about it because I do have a ton of florals, and B, I cut them out just specifically for this layout, so it's completely fine if I end up using them all up. I'm also trying not to create too many straight lines within my clusters, and I'm trying to break up if there are straight lines. So I don't want to have rows of florals. I want them to be on multiple levels, and if I see a row beginning, I will overlap some other florals to break up those rows. So that is something to keep in mind as well. Now, this floral I forgot I had. It's another one of the Chamel ones, and I was trying to find the right spot where it balanced out the layout. I didn't want the area around my photos to get too large because then it would make that trickle-down effect at the bottom look a little awkward. And so I did end up popping it up here at the top, which sort of undoes the lighter trickling down at the top that she had happening in her layout. But I'm okay with it. I was able to balance it out with this teal flower. So I have some of that teal in multiple places on the layout as well, and it works out pretty well. It breaks up the row of florals that I had there. Now I'm not just doing florals on this layout. I always come in with some little detail pieces, and this layout is no different. Now you will notice that I started out with taping these florals and now have jumped to using glue. The reason for that is the glue is faster, and if I've made a decision, okay, I want this to be here, then glue is just a faster way to get it down in place. Also, using glue will create a little bit more dimension. Your paper will sort of not crinkle up so much, but it will kind of warp a little bit. And when you're playing with florals, that's a good thing. It will give it just a little bit of lift and dimension, and it's not sitting perfectly flat on your page. Whereas I have taped down some of the background florals that I wanted to sit flat. And so we're just adding more texture, more interest to the layout. Not all of my florals that I've cut out were full florals. I knew I was going to be tucking in bits and pieces everywhere. And so I was okay with cutting out just a few that were half florals or at the edge of the page or something like that because I knew they could be tucked in. And I'm almost gotten all of these florals onto this page, and we're only 7 minutes into the video. This was a super fast layout, and I really enjoyed this. Floral clusters just make me happy. That's all there is to it. And with this last flower, I couldn't quite make it fit the way I wanted to, so I just go ahead and cut it in half and just tuck it back up in there where I would like it. I did try really hard to have a bit of a trickling down effect there at the end, so you have this feeling of movement like the florals are kind of cascading down the page. And I'm just going to do some very minor embellishing, bring in a few bits and pieces from my stash kit. I will link the unboxing to that below, as well as the playlist that has all of the videos I've made this month with this kit. It is based mostly on Chamel's Little by Little collection, which is an older collection that I have had in my stash for quite a while. And I'm bringing in as many ephemera pieces as I can, particularly these feathers, because I find feathers can be a bit tricky outside of floral clusters. I don't have any problem with tucking them into floral clusters. I think they have the same overall feel as florals, and so I really do like to tuck them in with floral clusters. But I find them difficult to use outside of floral clusters. I just feel like they're kind of an awkward item to add in. And I'm gonna bring in a couple of pieces to make my title. So I've got this ephemera piece that says Seek Beauty, and then I'm cutting out a pretty little studio banner piece that says it says Everyday Moments, I think, something like that. And my screen is much smaller as I'm watching the video and narrating. So I'm going to add in these little thickers, and I wanted to say seek beauty in everyday moments, I think is what that says. And I pull them out and realize, I'm out of E's. That's always the first alphabet to go for me. I also don't have A's on this thicker set, so I'm really stretching it. And I'm going to put in the, but I'm going to have to do some modification. Oh, I was out of eyes as well. I had to cut down an L to make an I and decided to use the little piece left over to turn this F into an E. We're making it work, people. Making it work. I have a feeling that this thicker set is not going to last too much longer, which is fine because it's foam. I just use it underneath of photos to prop them up instead of foam tape or craft foam. I'll just use extra foam thickers underneath of the photos for that purpose. It's the same thing. They still get used, and that way they don't get wasted. So now I'm pulling in my product focus for this month, which is wood veneer and cork. And I'm going to bring in these really cute tiny butterflies. Not a clue where they came from. They've been sitting in my stash for quite a while. I have a feeling they're probably maybe from jelly bean soup. Maybe. They have some confetti shakers that look similar. So I'm adding those little butterflies all around the page just for a little bit of detail and interest, and also because I adore butterflies, and given the opportunity, I would put them on every single page. I am also going to bring in some very sweet little enamel hearts. I always have the link for that in the description box below because I get a lot of questions about those. They're very, very tiny enamel hearts, and they are from Funny Sticker World. I have one great contact for them out of Korea, I believe. They're Korean based, and they are brilliant. They're tiny, they're enamel shapes, they're like enamel dots, but they're hearts, and they come in a variety of colors. So I am making use of as many as possible. I'm going to try to use especially a lot of the lime green ones because there is lime green on that page, and that's not a color that I use terribly often. Adding some Heidi Swap Color Shine around the outside because I love a good splattering, and I did want to go a little heavy-handed with the splattering on this layout because there is polka dots in the background already. Brought in some white Nouveau drops just to add a little dimension in the center of some of the flowers, especially the rose-shaped ones, and I thought that was just a nice little detail that it needed it. So this layout is done. I hope you will check out Miranda and her link below, and until next time, bye.